you. Thank you, Jim, everyone. Thank you. Thank you all very, very much. I love to see the energy in this convention. I love to see the energy in this room. And I'd love to see this energy that you have and the conviction that we share spread out across this state and across this land and replace those people that are undermining American exceptionalism every day and put our constitutional conservatives in office everywhere. And I especially appreciate the introduction from Kim Reynolds. We were telling a little discussion over on the side. She has defeated me in the only competition that we had that was head-to-head. It was the Celebrity Steer Show down in Decatur County. And she showed a steer and I showed a heifer. So, you know, sometimes you just have to buck up and try again. But we're in this situation here where this country, we have to do that. We have to buck up and try again. We let Barack Obama slip into the presidency almost 4 years ago. And we knew what he was. Republicans knew what he was. He has shown America what he is. We have one socialist in the United States Senate, self-professed Bernie Sanders. Barack Obama voted to the left of Bernie Sanders when he was in the Senate. And now look what he's done. He has done great violence, I think, to the Constitution of the United States. Before the Supreme Court now, and we will get a decision this month, maybe very soon, the President has had his Solicitor General argue that the Commerce Clause in the Constitution is so broad that it gives authority for an individual mandate that would require you to buy a health insurance policy that the government chooses, whether or not you participate in health care. And so they are arguing before the court that they have constitutional authority because to not do something is to do something. To non-participate is to participate, and whether it's interstate or intrastate, they're one and the same thing. If they get this done and the Supreme Court rules against our liberty, the Commerce Clause will have swallowed all of the enumerated powers in the Constitution and the Ninth Amendment and the Tenth Amendment. And to think how outrageous it is for a president of the United States who takes an oath to uphold the Constitution to take such a stand, he also argues that Arizona's immigration law is unconstitutional because there is an Obama policy that doesn't want them to enforce the law either. And so if that's the case, if the administration can change their policy and that makes state law unconstitutional, then that swallows up another chunk of the Constitution. And then along the way, oh, by the way, I just remember this little memo. It is, if you want to put into your Twitter account that the President of the United States is a former adjunct professor at the University of Chicago who taught constitutional law, you have to get that down to a limited number of characters, and that becomes ex-con law professor. So. And he's pushing debt and deficit on us that has never been seen in the history of this country. He offered a $1.33 trillion deficit spending budget for this fiscal year. The Senate wouldn't pass a budget, the President offered one, and our debt's gone from $10 trillion to $15.7 trillion in the time Barack Obama's been in office. It is unsustainable. My little granddaughter, my littlest granddaughter, was born in about a little over a year and a half ago. Her share of the national debt on that day was $44,000. Her name's Reagan Ann King. It is awesome. And on her first birthday, her share was $48,000. If she wanted to pay off her share of the national debt, by the time she was a year and a half, just a couple of months ago, her share was $51,000. And so is this little baby's share, $51,000 to pay off their share of the national debt. This is unsustainable. Governor Branstad said, we will become worse than Greece if we reelect Barack Obama. We can't let that happen. Now, and so I'm watching some of these other things that do violence to the Constitution, like executive orders. And I remember standing before this state convention 12 years ago when I announced that then Governor Vilsack could not legislate by executive order. His executive order number 7 granted special protected status for sexual orientation and gender identity by gubernatorial edict. and it amended the code of Iowa. It legislated by executive order, and I announced at this convention that I would sue Tom Vilsack 12 years ago at this convention. The case of King versus Vilsack is in the books. The court vacated his executive order and ruled for the separation of powers and the Constitution. Now I'm here to tell you that just yesterday, President Obama's executive order was announced. His executive order is an immigration executive order that he has himself said just a little more than a year ago he didn't have the authority to affect the implementation of what they call the DREAM Act by executive order. He acknowledged in a speech in Washington, D.C., March 28, 2011, that there is a separation of powers, that Congress has to write the laws. His job is to take care that they're faithfully carried out and the judicial branch interprets the laws. Pretty good, Mr. President. Sounds like an ex-con law professor to me. But 14 months later, he announced that he will issue an executive order to impose amnesty in this country on about a million people, in direct contradiction to the will of the people as reflected through votes in the United States Congress. That is an unconstitutional executive order. I'm here to tell you, I will bring suit against the President of the United States to block that executive order. Thank you. I think we agree. When you take an oath to uphold this Constitution, it's not just an oath that gets you a job in public office somewhere or puts a uniform on you. It's got to be deep from within our hearts. And we've got to believe that the words on that paper mean what they say. And we've got to interpret them to mean what they were understood to mean at the time of ratification, or it's no guarantee whatsoever. That's what I meant when I took the oath to uphold the Constitution, and it took a little out of my kids' inheritance, so be it. They'll get a country that's got more liberty and more constitutional values because of it. Now, it is imperative that we defeat Barack Obama in this race that comes up in November. Many things fall in behind that. Many things we'll get right if we can get that done. And I will tell you this, that we will bring a nominee in Tampa. And I want to see this Republican Party unified. We are focused on Tampa, but let's also focus on every Republican race at the state house race level, at our county level, every level here in the state of Iowa. Let's get our farm team in place and let's own this state. We can do it in this election. Now, I remember being a moderator in a presidential forum in Columbia, South Carolina last Labor Day. Jim DeMint and I and Robbie George asked questions of the presidential candidates. I remember when Mitt Romney came on the stage and I asked him, what is your opinion of Dodd-Frank? And he went off on about a minute and a half rant that Dodd and Frank caused the economic problem and then they were put in charge of the solution. He said, repeal Dodd-Frank. I said, fine, I'm for that. What would you do with the Community Investment Act? Repeal it. What would you do with Fannie and Freddie? Would you move them towards incremental privatization? Yes and yes. And I said, how about let's try to run the table. What would you do with Sarbanes-Oxley? Repeal it and implement sound regulations where we can make a profit. That's an economic policy sweep, in my opinion. Now, I trust Mitt Romney. I trust Mitt Romney to do the right thing. Some of you may not, but here's what you can trust. You can always trust Barack Obama to do the wrong thing. So let's pledge to join together in this convention, march out of this convention, deploy across the state of Iowa and down to Tampa and across this country and join together on our common cause of constitutional conservatism, fiscal responsibility, pro-life, pro-family, and this pro-strength of the American unity that rebuilds the pillars of American exceptionalism together. Let's go do that from this convention. God bless you.
Thank you, Jim.
Wonderful.
Thank you very much.